फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू बालकिशोर प्रीमियर एकेडमी, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट प्रीमियर इंस्टीट्यूट फॉर गेट आईएएस एंड पीएसयू एग्जामिनेशन।
इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इफेक्ट ऑफ स्कैटरिंग ऑन द मोबिलिटी। सो व्हाट विल बी द इफेक्ट ऑफ द स्कैटरिंग फेनोमेनास ऑन द मोबिलिटी ऑफ द चार्ज कैरियर्स। सो जनरली we know that in the previous video we have already discussed that how mobility arises. So if it is a semiconductor bar, and we know that there will be some electrons inside the semiconductor bar, and there will be some holes also inside the semiconductor bar. So I am drawing only one electron and one hole. Generally there will be so many electrons and so many holes. So we have applied a bias from the outside. So this is the V applied we have given. So this is the positive terminal, this is the negative terminal. So here it will be positive and here it will be negative. Now since we have applied potential across the semiconductor bar, so kya hoga ki semiconductor ke andar positive to negative direction pe ek electric field generate honge, and due to this electric field there will be some force on the electron, and this force on the electron will be directed in the opposite direction to the electric field generated, and force on the hole will be directed towards the negative polarity. So the electrons will move with some velocity, that is vdn, that is the drift velocity, and the hole will move with vdp velocity, that is the drift velocity for the holes. So in this way the electrons will move in the opposite direction to the electric field, and the hole will move in the same direction to the electric field. During this movement what happens, there will be so many atoms inside the semiconductor. So if I draw the atoms, so this will be the atoms. There are so many atoms. We know that inside the semiconductor, suppose silicon, there will be the atomic concentration. If I write the atomic concentration for silicon will be 5 into 10 to the power 22 atoms per centimeter cube. Itne sare atoms yahan pe rehte hain. So we are taking few of them. We cannot draw all of the atoms. Suppose these are the atoms of silicon. So when this electron and hole will move inside the semiconductor bar due to the application of the external electric field, so they will collide, or they will have some collision with these atoms, and these collisions of these atoms of the electron and the holes is called the scattering phenomena. So there will be several types of scattering phenomena present inside the semiconductor. So electrons and holes are scattered by different scattering agents inside the semiconductor. So depending on that we name different scattering phenomena. So we can write that electron and holes will be scattered by different scattering agents, and depending on this there are several types of scattering phenomena. So there will be different types of scattering phenomena inside the semiconductor bar. So what are the different scattering phenomena? So the first scattering phenomena that will be encountered by the electron and the holes during the movement inside the semiconductor bar is the lattice vibration. So it is called lattice scattering. Then the second type of scattering phenomena that will take place is called ionized impurity scattering. The third type of scattering phenomena that will take place is called alloy scattering. Similarly, the fourth one is called photon scattering. The fifth one is called chemical impurity scattering. And the sixth one is known as interface roughness scattering. And the last one is the carrier scattering. So these all are the different scattering phenomena that will take place inside the semiconductor for the movement of electrons and holes. Out of this different scattering mechanism, two phenomena are very dominant inside the semiconductors and it affects the carrier mobility. These two scattering phenomena are the lattice scattering phenomena. So this is the first lattice scattering phenomena that will be dominant, and the second one is the ionized impurity scattering phenomena. So these two scattering phenomena is very dominant inside the semiconductor and it will affect the mobility of the electrons and the holes. So let us discuss about this lattice scattering phenomena and the ionized impurity scattering phenomena. So we will first discuss about the lattice scattering phenomena. So our heading will now be lattice scattering phenomena. तो ये लैटिस स्कैटरिंग फेनोमेना क्या है इसको समझना होगा क्या होता है कि वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन दैट इनसाइड द सेमीकंडक्टर्स अकॉर्डिंग टू द एनर्जी बॉन्ड मॉडल देयर विल बी अ टू वी कैन ड्रॉ अ 2D रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द सेमीकंडक्टर्स सो इफ दीज आर द एटम्स ऑफ द सेमीकंडक्टर टेक अस टेक द सेमीकंडक्टर सिलिकॉन तो सिलिकॉन के अंदर हम लोग ये 2D रिप्रेजेंटेशन ड्रॉ कर सकते हैं अकॉर्डिंग टू द एनर्जी बॉन्ड मॉडल एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द एनर्जी बॉन्ड मॉडल सो दीज आर द एटम्स ऑफ द सिलिकॉन सेमीकंडक्टर एंड इन बिटवीन देम देयर विल बी कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड सो दीज आर द कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड यूजिंग दिस कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड दे आर इंटरकनेक्टेड with each other. So let me draw the covalent bonds. So each of the atom can be connected to 4 neighboring atoms. We have already seen that. So these are the covalent bonds and this is the total 2D representation that can be drawn for the silicon semiconductor. Now what will happen if we increase the temperature? Suppose we have some temperature T equals to 0 K. So if the temperature is at 0 K, we know there will be no vibration of the silicon atoms. ये जो silicon atoms है, ये सारे silicon atoms का कोई vibration नहीं होगा. अगर vibration नहीं होंगे तो कोई phonon particles नहीं होगा, कोई electrons नहीं होंगे और कोई holes भी नहीं होगा. इसीलिए T equals to 0 पे semiconductors insulator की तरह काम करते हैं. ये सारे चीज हमने energy bond model से देखा है. Now suppose if I increase the temperature beyond 0 Kelvin. अगर 0 Kelvin से beyond हम लोग temperature को increase करते हैं, so what will happen? So these atoms of the semiconductor will start vibrating. So they will start vibrating. This atom will also start vibrating. This atom will also start vibrating. So मैं जितना इसका temperature increase करूंगा, उतने सिलिकॉन एटम्स ज्यादा वाइब्रेशन में चले जाएंगे. सो ऑल ऑफ द एटम्स ऑफ द सेमीकंडक्टर विल स्टार्ट वाइब्रेटिंग. दैट मींस द वाइब्रेशन ऑफ दिस एटम्स इज आल्सो कॉल्ड द लैटिस वाइब्रेशन. एंड दिस लैटिस वाइब्रेशन विल टेक प्लेस ड्यू टू द इंक्रीमेंट ऑफ द टेम्परेचर. और टेम्परेचर इंक्रीमेंट करने से क्या होता है कि थर्मल एनर्जी ज्यादा होता है और सिलिकॉन एटम वो थर्मल एनर्जी लेके वाइब्रेशन मोड में चले जाते हैं. और हम लोग बोलते हैं नाउ द सेमीकंडक्टर एटम्स आर इन द एजिटेशन मोड. नाउ इफ वी इंक्रीज, सो मैंने क्या देखा कि इफ वी इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर बियॉन्ड 0 केल्विन, सो द एटम्स ऑफ द सेमीकंडक्टर विल स्टार्ट वाइब्रेशन. अगर वाइब्रेशन स्टार्ट कर देते हैं तो हम लोग बोल सकते हैं कि लैटिस वाइब्रेशन विल टेक प्लेस. लैटिस वाइब्रेशन चालू हो जाएंगे. एंड दिस लैटिस वाइब्रेशन विल कॉज डिसरप्शन इन द परफेक्ट पीरियोडिक क्रिस्टल. तो ये लैटिस वाइब्रेशन की वजह से क्या होगा कि इट विल कॉज अ डिसरप्शन इन द परफेक्ट पीरियडिक स्ट्रक्चर. ये जो सेमीकंडक्टर्स का पीरियडिक स्ट्रक्चर होता है उसमें थोड़ा सा डिस्टरबेंस प्रोड्यूस करेंगे ड्यू टू दिस वाइब्रेशन. नाउ सपोज इफ वी हैव सम इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड इफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इज मूविंग इन दिस मैनर थ्रू दिस सेमीकंडक्टर पीरियडिक स्ट्रक्चर, देन व्हाट विल हैपन? दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड द एटम्स आर वाइब्रेटिंग. सो दिस एटम्स आर वाइब्रेटिंग सिलिकॉन्स. So the electron can be collide with these silicon atoms because they are vibrating in this way. All of them are vibrating. So kya probability hai ki electron ye lattice atoms se collide hoke scattering produce ho jayenge. So hum log bol sakte hain due to this vibration there is a possibility that the interaction between the electron or holes and the vibrating atoms take place. So vibrating atoms ke saath electrons or holes ka kuch interaction chalu ho jayenge. And this phenomena of interaction is called the lattice scattering. Sometimes this is also called the phonon scattering because the atoms are displaced due to the vibration. So it is called phonon scattering also. So phonon scattering and lattice scatterings are both the same thing. तो मैंने देखा कि जितना टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज करेंगे, इसका टेम्परेचर जितना इंक्रीज करेंगे, वाइब्रेशन ऑफ द एटम उतना ज़्यादा होगा. जितना ज़्यादा वाइब्रेशन होंगे उतने ज़्यादा देर इज़ अ प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ इंटरेक्शन उतने ज़्यादा होंगे. सो हम लोग लिख सकते हैं प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ इंटरेक्शन विल बी मोर. If the probability of interaction is more, so we can say the scattering will be more. So scattering का probability ज़्यादा हो जाएंगे. That means, as we increase the temperature, so we can say for the lattice scattering that if we increase the temperature, then the phonon scattering, phonon scattering will be very dominant and phonon scattering अगर ज्यादा होता है तो mobility of the electron and holes will be less. जितने ज्यादा scattering होंगे उतने mobility कम होगा. That's why if we denote this phonon scattering or lattice scattering as mu L, then it is found experimentally that mu L is proportional to the t to the power minus 3 by 2. So the phonon scattering or the lattice scattering experimentally found kiya gaya hai, ye wala relation, it is proportional to the temperature to the power minus 3 by 2, where mu L is the mobility of the carriers that would be observed if only the lattice scattering existed inside the crystal. So, ये जो mu L है, this mu L क्या है? Mu L is nothing but the mobility of charge carriers that would be observed if only lattice scattering is present inside the semiconductor. अगर semiconductor के अंदर सिर्फ lattice scattering होता तो mobility of the carriers will be mu L. And that mu L is proportional to the t to the power minus 3 by 2 and this t is the temperature. So जितना ज्यादा temperature होंगे phonon scattering उतना ज्यादा होगा और आपका मोबिलिटी उतना कम हो जाएंगे. सो दिस वाज ऑल अबाउट द फोनॉन स्कैटरिंग और द लैटिस स्कैटरिंग. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द आयोनाइज्ड इंप्यूरिटी स्कैटरिंग. सो लेट अस सी व्हाट इज आयोनाइज्ड इंप्यूरिटी स्कैटरिंग. सो फॉर दैट लेट अस पुट अ हेडिंग दैट आयोनाइज्ड impurity scattering. So what is ionized impurity scattering? Ionized impurity scattering का मतलब होता है कि if we have a semiconductor, suppose if this is a semiconductor bar and inside the semiconductor bar then suppose this is a silicon semiconductor bar. If this is a silicon semiconductor bar, so then there will be atoms of silicon only. If it is a pure semiconductor, so these are the atoms of silicon. So if we want to make it extrinsic and if we want to control the characteristics of the silicon semiconductor, then what we'll do, we have to dope this semiconductor. We have to dope this semiconductor with impurity. So if we dope this semiconductor, suppose when we dope this semiconductor with some impurity atoms, then the impurity atoms will take place or will replace some of the silicon atoms. So let us assume that these atoms are replaced by the impurity atoms. So these are the impurity atoms. And these impurity atoms are added inside the silicon semiconductor to control the characteristics or electrical characteristics of the silicon semiconductor. And they will either donate the electrons or they will donate holes inside the semiconductor. So after donating the electrons and holes inside the semiconductor, this impurity atom will become ionized. That means the impurity atom, if the impurity atom donates electron, then this impurity atom will be positively charged. And if the impurity atom donates holes, then the impurity atom will become negatively charged. That means after the donating the electron and holes, the impurity atom will become, either they become positive or they become negatively charged. And this is called ionized impurity. And these charged impurity are called ionized impurity atoms. And scattering phenomena will occur due to this ionized impurity atom. So तो हमने क्या देखा कि अभी कि इम्प्यूरिटी एटम्स आर एडेड इन द सेमीकंडक्टर टू कंट्रोल देयर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एंड एट रूम टेम्परेचर व्हाट विल हैपन कि द दिस इम्प्यूरिटी एटम्स सो दिस इम्प्यूरिटी एटम्स will be ionized. ये ionized हो जाते हैं. अगर ionized हो जाएंगे तो either they will be positive charge or they will be negative charge. That means either they will be negatively charged or positively charged. तो जैसे ही ionized होंगे तो क्या होगा, there will be a coulombic attraction or repulsion force, so we can say a coulombic interaction exists between the ionized impurity atom, and electrons or holes. So जैसे impurity atoms ionized हो जाते हैं, तो ionized होने का मतलब क्या होता है? Either they will be positive charge or negative charge. तो ये positive negative ionized impurity atom के साथ electrons और holes के बीच में, दोनों के बीच में एक coulombic attraction force create हो जाता है. जैसे ये coulombic attraction force create होंगे, so they will be producing some scattering phenomena. Suppose मान लीजिए, so पहले यहाँ पे लिख लेते हैं कि this coulombic attraction force, that means it will produce right now, it will produce a scattering phenomena. So it will produce the scattering phenomenons and alter the velocity of the particles and alter the velocity of the particles. So particle ka velocity alter karte, particle ka matlab kya hota hai, electrons and holes. Suppose we have a scattering like this. Suppose we have an ionized impurity atom which is positively charged. So we have taken it as positively charged ionized impurity. And suppose an electron is coming from this direction. So if this electron is coming, then there will be a attraction force created between this electron and the ionized impurity atom. So the velocity Vdn will be increased. And suppose if we have a ionized impurity of negative charge, then the electron which is coming in this direction, it will be repelled like this. So it will be repelled in this way. So the velocity will be changed. So these are the scatterings that is caused by the ionized impurity atoms, and this is called the ionized impurity scattering. Now if T is increased, what will happen? If the temperature capital T is increased, if the temperature capital T is increased, then what happened? The first thing is that the thermal velocity of the electrons and holes, thermal velocity of electron and holes will be increased. Ye increase hoga. Jaise hi thermal velocity of the electrons and holes will be increased, tab kya honge? It will reduce the time spent in the vicinity of the coulombic force. So ye coulombic force ke field ke andar कम टाइम स्पेंड करेंगे किस क्योंकि इलेक्ट्रॉन्स और होल्स इसका वेलोसिटी ज्यादा है. सो वी कैन राइट दैट द इफ वी इंक्रीज द टाइम देन द थर्मल वेलोसिटी ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड होल्स विल बी इंक्रीज्ड. दैट्स व्हाई इट विल रिड्यूस द टाइम स्पेंड in the vicinity of the coulombic force. Coulombic force field में एक कम समय रुकेंगे. जितना कम समय रुकेंगे तो क्या होगा कि scattering उतना कम होगा. So there will be smaller amount of scattering. So smaller amount of scattering will take place. Will happen. So हमने देखा कि ionized impurity atoms के लिए, so ionized impurity scattering के लिए क्या हो रहा है कि जितना मैं temperature को increase करता हूँ, so scattering due to ionized impurity atoms, ionized scattering due to ionized impurity atoms will decrease. That means the ionized impurity scattering phenomena will be dominant for the low temperature. And suppose mu i is the mobility of the charge carriers, if mu i is the mobility of charge carriers, that would be observed if only impurity scattering existed, अगर सिर्फ impurity scattering exist करता है semiconductor के अंदर, तो semiconductor के अंदर जो charge carriers है, उसका जो mobility होगा, that mobility को मैं बोल रहा हूँ mu i. So this mu I will be proportional to the power t to the power 3 by 2. क्योंकि जितना टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज होंगे दैट इम्प्यूरिटी स्कैटरिंग फेनोमेना उतना डिक्रीज होंगे. तो हमने देखा वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ स्कैटरिंग फेनोमेना दैट विल बी डोमिनेंट इनसाइड द सेमीकंडक्टर. क्या क्या है दो इम्प्यूरिटी फेनोमेनन्स है. सो स्कैटरिंग फेनोमेना, पहला स्कैटरिंग फेनोमेना था लैटिस स्कैटरिंग फेनोमेना. तो पहला वाला था लैटिस स्कैटरिंग और हमने देखा कि लैटिस स्कैटरिंग टेम्परेचर के साथ ये वाला लैटिस स्कैटरिंग क्या होता है डिक्रीज होता है, सॉरी डिक्रीज नहीं होता है, ये इंक्रीज हो जाता है. तो जितना टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज करेंगे लैटिस स्कैटरिंग फेनोमेना उतना इंक्रीज होगा. सिमिलरली हमने देखा कि इम्प्यूरिटी स्कैटरिंग फेनोमेना है, रेदर इट इज आयोनाइज्ड इम्प्यूरिटी स्कैटरिंग. सो आयोनाइज्ड इम्प्यूरिटी स्कैटरिंग फेनोमेना जो होता है दैट इज इफ वी इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर देन द अमाउंट ऑफ आयोनाइज्ड इम्प्यूरिटी स्कैटरिंग फेनोमेना इट विल बी डिक्रीज्ड. और ये भी देखा था हमने कि इफ द मोबिलिटी of the particles due to the impurity scattering phenomena is mu I, then mu I is proportional to the power t to the power 3 by 2. Similarly, for lattice scattering, if the mobility is denoted by mu L, then it will be proportional to t to the power minus 3 by 2. Now, if we want to plot, ये तो था scattering के बारे में. So now if we want to plot about the mobility versus the temperature in the log scale, so suppose we are taking the x-axis as the temperature. So this is the temperature scale, temperature, and it is in log scale. And in the y-axis, we are taking the mobility value. So, in the y-axis, we are taking the mobility. So, what will be the plot look like? So, I am denoting here a temperature 100K. So, below the 100K temperature, what will happen? The impurity scattering will be dominant. So, the curve will look like this. If we have the curve, then it will look like this. In the below that 100K, the mobility will increase, and after 100K, the mobility will decrease like this. And at this point, the mobility will be maximum at 100K. तो 100 के पे मोबिलिटी मेरा मैक्सिमम होगा एंड बिलो द 100 के द मोबिलिटी इंक्रीजेस एंड हियर द इम्प्यूरिटी स्कैटरिंग दैट इज द आयोनाइज्ड इम्प्यूरिटी स्कैटरिंग विल बी डोमिनेंट. दैट्स व्हाई वी कैन राइट हियर द मोबिलिटी इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू द टी टू द पावर 3 बाय 2 बट above 100K, the mobility decreases and here the lattice scattering will be dominant because lattice scattering is dominant for higher temperature. So, the mobility will be proportional to the t to the power minus 3 by 2. And this will be the plot of the mobility for the entire temperature inside the semiconductor. So this is the mobility plot of the charge carriers inside the semiconductor, which depends on the different scattering phenomena. And the most important scattering phenomena that will be dominant inside the semiconductor is the impurity scattering and the lattice scattering. So mobility of the third carrier inside the semiconductor decreases non-linearly with temperature. ये generally हम लोग बोलते हैं क्योंकि यहाँ पे अगर 100 के हैं तो कुछ इधर मेरा 300 के होगा. So in above the 300 के मतलब ये मेरा normal temperature है. This is my normal temperature. So normal temperature के बाद mobility generally decreases with the temperature. So we can say that mobility of charge carriers decreases with temperature after normal temperature. This is an important conclusion. So this is all about how the mobility is dependent on the different scattering phenomena.
In the end, do not forget to like and subscribe our channel to get more videos. Thank you.